So yesterday I went out and I got one of these made. It's a wrecking anchor. It's used for bombing into wrecks and on reefs, and this will actually bend out. It was made by one of the boatmen down at the fishing club, Ian Martin. He's a friend of mine, and I'll take you through how we made it and how it's used. This goes directly onto your rope. You don't have a chain or anything, so I've got a shackle on the front of my rope that I'll undo that and connect it to this eye here. And these are made out of Rio bar, and they will literally just bend out. So you'll bomb this down into the wreck, and then when you go to retrieve it, these will bend out, and so you don't lose your anchor. It's an ideal way of fishing for bream and other species, and when it's wind against tide, this will keep you directly on the wreck, and then you don't lose your main anchor. So basically, that's a loop I've put in my rope, and that goes onto a shackle like that, and then goes onto my chain. So I've just taken my chain off, and this will go directly onto that loop with that shackle, and then you bomb that straight down into the wreck. And then when you want to put your normal anchor back on, you just undo this shackle and connect it back to your chain. Well, it's a bit noisy. Ian's cutting down the bar. And these are the rods that we're going to use, and a loop that we're putting on the top. All right, so what he's going to do now, he's going to weld these Rio bars to this scaffold tube. I'll just come out here while he's doing that. Right, while I'm waiting for the pot to heat up, I'll walk you around and show you some of the fishing club. Come on, you two. This is my club, East Hastings Angling Association. I had a boat here for many years. This is a runway here where they pull the boats out. This is my old one. Sailor, which is a 20 foot Wilson flyer, an absolute beast. I've had some really nice fish in this boat. There's the boatman's own boat there. And what we do is we drag these boats out. And up the end there is a winch that you can see. So we go through the gate there and then winch them down on these froze plastics. And there's like a camera up there so they can see in the winch room for a safety reason. And over there, that's a commercial beach. There, the boatman does the fish, and this is our workshop. I think you see a previous video where I made some lead weights up here. There's Ian doing the welding now, and Ian's tacked one piece on there already, and that'll bend through, and then we'll fill it with lead. Few more perks of being down the boat club. fresh peppered mackerel. Beautiful. Right, you can see the lead is completely melted now. Ian's just finished the welding, so we're going to let it cool down a bit. Let's have a quick look. Look, the dogs love it down here. There's my bestie. There's the baby. Then what we're going to do, we're going to pour the lead inside it to give it the weight. That should be good to go. Right, so we've just finished the sacrificial anchor, and Ian, one of the boatmen, has done it for me. So basically he welded the three bits of Rio bar onto a scaffold tube, put a loop on the end there, and then we put a wedge inside and filled it with lead. So I'm going to give that about 20 minutes to cool down, and then I'm going to attempt to bend these over. Hopefully the weld holds, and then I think what I'll do is I'll probably put some black hammerite on there and just jazz it up a bit. But as I said, it's not going on a yacht. It's just literally to bomb the anchor into a wreck and or on a reef, so that it'll pull out. You know, you don't want to get it stuck. If you don't have a chain on this, you literally just connect your... So I can unclip my chain and my other anchor and put the clip directly onto that that U-bend there and bomb it down straight into the reef or into a wreck, and then it should pull out. Okay, so this is the finished item. So as you can see, I've just painted it white with some metal paint, and these prongs are that long. It's quite heavy, that's why I'm struggling a bit. But these prongs are that long, so that'll easy bend out. So hopefully the next video you'll see this bombing down into the bottom of the wreck, and it should hopefully come out. I'd just like to thank Les the boatman and Ian Martin, who done all the welding and the work on this. I didn't do it myself, yeah, fantastic. Thanks for watching the video. At the end of this video, you'll get a prompt for another video, and then you'll see the Manic Fishing logo. If you can hit that Manic Fishing logo, that's my subscribe button. So hit that, and please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. And please tell a friend about the channel. Hope you're enjoying Manic Mondays. See you on the next one.